Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel VTNGT Vlogs. Today in this video I am going to tell you about the difference between the H8 and H11 bulb. So these bulbs usually fit into the fog lamps, as I have already showed in my previous video how to remove a fog lamp from a Skoda Rapid. So as you can, as I have already told, like company fitted are the H8s, and we are planning to fit, like what happens with H8 is it's a 35 watt bulb which has less brightness compared to H11. So when we see H11, it is 55 watt bulb, so it has better brightness and coverage on road. So what is the difference between which do not allow to directly fit in the H11 in H8's slot? So the only difference that I could find is first is the wattage, and another is this particular clip. On H11, this clip is bigger. It's broader in size on H11s, and on H8 it's a bit narrower. So to fit in H11 into the slot of H8s, what you need to do is just to clip this portion, a bit of it from that from the clip, so that it can match the size of this clip at the top and you can directly fit in. Other than that, there is no difference between these lights at all. So what I have done over here is I have already clipped this section of H11, which is a brighter bulb compared to H8. I have already clipped in, and we have this fog lamp from my Skoda Rapid which fits H8. So there is nothing that we need to worry on that part, because I already have clipped the top of H11. You just need to put in here in the slot, match it up, and you just need to rotate it clockwise and it fits in. It is present in this fog lamp. So just clipping the clip allows you to fit H11 in the space of H8. Now moving on to, like, I would just like to give additional information how to adjust your light from lower range to a higher range when it falls on the road. So this particular section, it has the lines over there. Like if you rotate this particular hinge over here, it will adjust your light up or down when it is fitted on your car. So like when I have made it in this position where it should go in the upward direction, so I'll create a video, or maybe I'll attach in the same video, where I'll be putting this light back in the car and show you how it is aligned. I'll not align the already company fitted or existing alignment that is there. We'll check this alignment that I have made some changes to. You moving this clip over here, hinge over here. So let's see how it goes ahead, and we'll get to see the angle that comes up. I won't suggest anyone to make angle in a way where it is like causing glare on the eyes of the people that are coming in opposite direction of yours. So make sure that fog lamps are not aligning others. Those are falling on the road and giving you a better visibility of the road and the side barriers that may come up. To showcase you the difference between the headlights from the fog reflector, I just put on both the reflectors, the fog lamps on in my car, and this is how it looks. So like I have adjusted the left one the way I have showcased in you in the video, and the right one is as per the company fitments. So if I cover up the company fitted one, you get to see how the line is there at the towards the top. Like if I show you, the line is here. Now I'll just uncover the right one and show you how it appears.
it's nowhere on the wall at all. So like, as you can see, towards the left, it's there on the wall. The left one is there on the wall, I'm covering it, and right one is not at all there. So, and when you sit inside the car, I'll showcase with that also. When you are inside the car and you see the view, the one, like this is the height, eye height of myself sitting inside the car, and you can see the one which is going towards the wall is more better than the one which is not going. Like when you see, you, because of the hood and the height of the car, you just get to see the section that is there at the top. So like increasing the height over there would always help you to look at the distance, and it won't glare in the eyes of the people that are coming towards you. So I'll add this to the video that we have already created to adjust the height of fog lamp. If you like it, share, like I would say, hit the like button, and if you want, share it, subscribe it. Thank you.